It's 3:15, and that means it's time for...
The Real Deal with Bill McNeil.
That's right. Welcome once again to The Real Deal with Bill McNeil. I'm your host, Bill McNeil, and you're probably wondering exactly what is The Real Deal today.
Hey, good question.
Welcome back to Thinking Critical. This is Wes. We've got some major independent comic book news coming out of New York City Comic Con this weekend. We have the announcement that finally coming off of hiatus is Saga from Brian K. Vaughan and Fiona Staples. Now, this has been over 3 years. Remember when they decided to go on a hiatus? It didn't. Well, I don't think anyone, including Vaughan or Staples, probably expected the hiatus to last quite exactly 3.5 years. But during the In Conversation with Brian K. Vaughan panel at New York City Comic Con, he announced that the two are returning to the series. Saga, of course, is an award-winning comic series from publisher Image Comics. And it's going to be returning at Saga number 55 on January 26th of 2022 in a special double-length 44-page comic book available for $2.99. It sounds like they might be sticking with that $2.99 price point, which, of course, is, I think, helped the sales of Spawn from Todd McFarlane, obviously one of the big head honchos at Image Comics. I also think the increased interest as Spawn went up and broke the record, and the fact that he maintained quality when it got there also helped the sales, but it certainly increased dramatically in sales over the last 4 or 5 years. And it's now one of the better selling indie comics within the entire market. That's one of the interesting things I'm going to get to here in a few seconds after I get through all the details of the return and why they went on hiatus, is they are coming back to a comic book market that is completely different than the one they left 3.5 years ago. Not only just because of the pandemic, but there are a lot of other factors that have happened. The market has changed, and we shall see if Saga is ready for a big return. I have a feeling that many of you probably are fans of Saga, and it's going to do very, very well with the current state of the market. Me personally, full disclosure, I have read some Saga, not the biggest fan. You say, Wes, you know what, Romeo and Juliet, like in some kind of weird sci-fi fantasy or space fantasy setting? Well, certainly that seems like it would be in my wheelhouse, but just the tone of the comic book and a lot of the stories they tell just aren't my cup of tea, but I can absolutely see why people love Saga, and it was an independent comic phenomenon. It was one of the really, the few independent comics that was really selling when it went away. It was a big loss. We had Saga leave, go on hiatus, then we had Walking Dead abruptly canceled. And we're like, what are Image Comics going to do? The only comic they have that's really doing better was Spawn, and it's doing even better now. But I thought maybe at one point, Die would be the comic book that would be able to take Saga's place. I thought that was a really wonderful series, fantastic art. Unfortunately, once you got to know the main characters, it turned out they're all bad people. And so I just kind of stopped reading it, because why would I want to read a comic book about terrible people trying to escape hell? Not really my thing. But it felt like Die was going to do it. That did not happen. But there have been a slew, and I do mean a slew, of independent comics released, launched within the last 18 months that have absolutely taken the place of Saga, and they are going to find it very competitive within the independent comic scene right now. For those of you who are unfamiliar with Saga, and I don't think there's going to be a whole lot of you, but it did run for 54 issues from 2012 to 2018. Used to take little mini 2-3 month breaks here and there. It has sold 7 million copies to date across the comic book, graphic novel, hardcover editions, all that kind of stuff. And certainly, it's one of the few comics on the indie scene that really breaks outside of like the comic book reading audience. There are people that read Saga in no other comic books because it speaks to them, and it's something that they're very interested in. We need more comic books like Saga, and I do think there are going to be a couple of breakouts out there. I think I have a feeling that when something is killing the children, it ends up hitting the streaming services. Once people get a load of that comic book, that one's actually going to have a breakout as well. It'll probably have a second life, similar to what we're seeing right now with Robert Kirkman's Invincible after it had that big breakout on Amazon Prime. Now the team are going to come back. They're going to do another 54 issues. I guess this was always planned to be 108 issue saga for the Saga series. And in the letters column, if you remember at issue number 54, this is what Brian K. Vaughan himself had wrote or written to his fans and readers after 54 issues and covering over 1,200 consecutive pages of sequential storytelling together. Fiona and I have decided to take an extended break before we eventually reunite with Saga 55. And unlike our usual 3 months of vacationaza, whatever that is, between arcs, we plan to pause publication of the series for at least the next year. The original rumors that were that it was going to last about a year and a half. Turns out that was way undersold. It ended up being about a 3.5 year break before we finally see issue 55 release. This is what Image Chief Creative Officer and Publisher Eric Stevenson had to say. Quote, Saga launched at Image during the company's 20th anniversary in 2012, so it seems more than fitting that the series is returning to shops just in time for our 30th anniversary next year. I can think of few better ways to celebrate what Image is all about than by welcoming back one of the most incredible storytelling teams in comics history as they embark on the second half of a true epic in the making. And that's what Eric Stevenson had to say. This is what Brian K. Vaughan himself had to say. Other than my own family, collaborating with Fiona Staples on Saga is the most important thing in my life. So I can't thank readers and retailers enough for their patience. I think our next 54 issues will be even more shocking, strange, and spectacular than the first 54. So we can't wait to get to be back on the shelves at your local comic shop shop soon. Oh my goodness, was that a tongue teaser there? And I imagine a lot of people, including Image Comics, are going to be very excited to see this come back. Now, if you recall, issue 54 of Saga released in July of 2018. Now, what was happening in July of 2018? Doomsday Clock was on issue number 5, right? The much maligned and delayed Doomsday Clock. Batman 50 had just released and had 440,000 sales. Batman 50, the wedding that never happened. The comic book that essentially killed Tom King's reputation at Batman and tanked sales of Batman all the way down to about 69,000 before they ended up replacing him about 20 issues early with James Tynion. Supposed to be temporary, ended up being a permanent change. Well, they thought it was permanent. It wasn't permanent. And then we also had the relaunches of Captain America and Amazing Spider-Man under Ta-Nehisi Coates and Nick Spencer. Obviously, Nick Spencer's run was a lot more successful. We are up to issue 75 right now of Amazing Spider-Man. Captain America is not being released at this time. And when you look at the indie scene, it was far different. You look at the 30K cutoff, that's what I'm going to use. There were 4 comics on the indie scene that were able to ship over 30,000 issues in July 2018. Oblivion Song shipped 30,000. Magic Order, 31,000. I believe both of those are over. Saga, 36,000. And the number one indie comic was The Walking Dead at 67,000. Also gone as far as a publishing entity. No longer getting Walking Dead. Now, in January 2022, Saga 55 relaunches. As I mentioned, no Captain America. Amazing Spider-Man is on issue number 75. Right now, it'll be on issue, my goodness, like 87, something like that. It'll be in the 80s, mid-80s, close to 90, by the time Saga 55 comes out, with a whole new creative team, got 5 writers. Gotham City has been taken over 3 times since Saga went down. We had City of Bane, we had Joker War, and now we have Fear State. By the time Saga comes back in January 2022, that is a lot of Gotham City being taken over by bad people. And if you look at the indie comic sales and the indie comic market, it is different. As I mentioned before, there were 4 independent comics that were able to hit the 30,000 comic ship threshold in July 2018. And in August 2021, there were 11, almost 3 times as many. IDW Star Wars High Republic did 33,000. Nocterra, obviously Scott Snyder, 33,000. Masters of the Universe Revelation, 34,000. Don't know that that one will keep up those numbers. Echo Lands, 36,000. Geiger, 37,000. So before, we still have Jeff Johns doing Doomsday Clock, and he had yet to even release Batman 3 Jokers. Now, He's over at Image Comics with Geiger. Skybound X, 41K. Obviously, that's Robert Kirkman's anthology that he's doing. I believe that one's over now. Eat the Rich. I'm sorry. Ice Cream Man, 52K. Eat the Rich at 61,000. Me, You Love in the Dark, 69,000. That is absolutely insane. I read that comic book. I was kind of excited because I like Scotty Young. And that is one of the most boring comic books I've ever read in my life. Me, You Love in the Dark, number one, was absolutely worthless. If you loved it, hey, you and I just disagree on what good comic book storytelling is, because that thing was the most flaccid, boring thing I've ever read in my life. And there's no way it's going to even be able to keep up those numbers, because that was a terrible first impression. But number one at the independent comic box office was King Spawn with 479,000. Obviously, they're not going to be able to replicate that very often, but we do have Gunslinger Spawn, which looks like it's probably going to exceed 450,000. So they got some other winners out there. And interesting enough, in August of 2021, two of the bigger, more consistent, best-selling independent comics weren't even released. They took a skip month. Berserker in July, on I believe issue number 4, shipped 68,000 comics, and Spawn at issue like 311, 312, something like that, did 63,000 issues. So actually it was more like 13 up there. Although there were some number one launches that bumped the numbers, but it is a entirely different scene for independent comics now. People are turning kind of away from the big two, and they are definitely buying all in on independent comics. That's why you see Scott Snyder definitely stepping out. He's not even writing anything at DC at the moment other than Batman Fortnite one-shot, but he's writing comic books over at Image. He's also got some works that are going to be up on Comixology, Scottober, whatever the stupid thing they're calling it, which will eventually be released on Dark Horse. You've got James Tynan, got projects over at Boom. He's got projects over at Image. I forgot. His Something is Killing the Children shipped 43,000. I think I forgot to mention that one. So he's got two comics that are over that threshold. He's absolutely doing fantastic. So a lot of these big-name creators, you know, Jeff Johns, Scott Snyder, James Tynan, going over to the indie scene, seeing a lot of success. We've also got some other creators out there, Al Ewing and others, that are turning a blind eye to the big two and looking over the indie comic scene. So Saga is going to have a lot of competition, but I think they're also going to find an audience that are salivating, waiting for more Saga. Sometimes you can wait long enough that it just makes the appetite grow, and people don't just kind of forget. I don't think people are going to forget about Saga. I think this is something that a lot of people have been looking for, and they're going to be excited for, and I think it is going to go right in there, probably issue 55, the relaunch. I'll be shocked if it doesn't go over like 120. I imagine they're going to do a lot of variant covers, because Image and DC have definitely followed Marvel Comics' lead. You're going to see a lot of store-exclusive variants. You don't have to go through Penguin Random House, right? Why invest on a new number one at Marvel Comics when you got an uncertain market and what your comic's going to show up like? When you go over there to Image, you can do one for Saga. There's going to be a lot of people coming in for that thing anyway. Get some store-exclusive. So that thing is going to sell like hotcakes. And I think it's going to be well received. People like Brian K. Vaughan, and I think people love Fiona Staples' art as well. So that's the big news. Saga is still on hiatus, but not very much longer. On January 26th of the year 2022, it is returning after three and a half year hiatus to a completely different market. We've had the pandemic. We had everything open up. We no longer have a monopoly as far as distribution. We got three comic book distributors, and we have a ton of very high best-selling independent comic books for Saga to compete with.
If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. I would appreciate it very much. It helps us attract more views for the channel. Subscribe for future commentary, comic book news, and reviews. And don't forget to ring the bell for notifications. If you want to talk comics, movies, and much, much more, you can follow me on Twitter, @Wes_from_TC. With that, Salamat Po, and I'm out.